everyone, and welcome back to In the Spotlight. Today, we're featuring the Hellenic Film Society of the United States of America, and they are celebrating 200 years of Greek independence. Now, the wonderful thing about the Hellenic Film Society of the United States is that they're here to specifically promote Greek films in the United States, and they want to share the richness of Greek films with a wider American audience. And that's awesome, because that's going to get a chance for all these Greek films to be showcased and to preserve the Greek heritage. So we are very happy to have with us the board members and the president of the Hellenic Film Society of the United States. We have Jimmy Demetro, we have George Stephanopoulos, and we have Kostandina Kunurgres from Los Angeles. And the wonderful thing about Zoom is that we all can just be anywhere around the world and be able to do these shows today. And I'm very happy about that. So welcome, guys. Welcome to In the Spotlight on New Greek Television. We're so excited to hear about everything you're doing with your new platform. Jimmy, can you tell us a little bit more about what you guys are doing?
Absolutely, Yanna. First of all, let me thank you for giving us the opportunity to speak with you and your audience. We much appreciate it. We're kind of excited about what's going to go on this month. We're, as you mentioned, in celebrating the 200 years of Greek independence. We wanted to do something special for our audience. And so we have come up with this idea of presenting a series of films, a total of eight, that have been inspired by Greek history. Two of the films specifically deal with the period of the Greek Revolution, but the timeline goes from antiquity to the present. It's quite an eclectic selection of films. It will surprise many viewers. There are just interesting choices and that we're very excited about sharing with people all over the world. Since the pandemic and the closing of the theaters, we have moved our focus on operating online, and we've created a monthly series of where we feature usually two Greek films, older films, each month. We feel that there are many, many worthwhile older films that are literally on the shelf, not being seen anymore, and they deserve a better fate than that. And so this is what the mindset is behind this monthly streaming.
Jimmy, that's wonderful. So tell me a little bit about the dates here. We're looking at what dates are we beginning this
year? Yes, well, this particular program will be available from March 19th to the 28th. And as I said, it's a wide selection of films to be enjoyed.
I'm very excited because your lineup is really amazing. I mean, Blood of Zeus, Cliffs of Freedom, Marathon Run, God Loves Caviar, Beneath the Olive Tree, America, America. All right, I want to hear how you've gotten these films.
So, Yanna, I'll jump in here just to, you know, let you know that we started, obviously, with Cliffs of Freedom, right? That's the sort of the definitive film on the Greek Revolution, which was set in, you know, 1821. And we are so fortunate that the film was made available to us by the National Hellenic Society and Art Demopoulos and all the members there. So I don't know that we would have done this if we couldn't have had access to that film. And it, so, it, you know, and I don't know why we would even attempt to show anything where we're, and to celebrate the 200 year Greek War of Independence if we weren't showing that film.
Another great thing about Cliffs of Freedom is that this director, Van Ling, he worked with James Cameron. Can you tell us a little bit more about him? And I think you have a surprise for the viewers as well.
Actually, we were able to get an interview with the director, Van Ling. He's a man who's worked in many fields, in many different aspects of the movie field. This is his first feature film directing debut. Part of the interview are the stars of the film. Kostas Mandalor, who joins the interview from Athens. And also we have Tanya Raymond, who has the female lead, and Jan Udin, who's the male lead. They are wonderful, wonderful people. And they they have so much love for one another and so much respect for one another. And that comes through in the interview. They're so genuinely pleased. It's almost like a reunion for them to have the group together again, talking about their work. It's a good interview.
And I should just add to that, that Tom Papadimitriou, who chairs the
group. Absolutely, absolutely. Tom Papadimitriou, who's a professor of Ottoman history and heads the Greek studies program at Stockton University in New Jersey. A terrific man, very accomplished. And I was so happy that he's part of the interview.
I cannot wait to see all these interviews with the creators and the actors.
Yeah, it's always fun to hear directors and actors talk about their work on a particular film. It's so revealing. I find it fascinating.
So it all started with Cliffs of Freedom. And then from there, in talking to Jimmy and others on the board, we realized there weren't a lot of other films, available to us. There might've been some documentary films on RTV in Greek, but without English subtitles. And so we were sort of limited in terms of what else we might want to program. But then it became clear that we could show God Loves Caviar, which was a film that we've shown before, which takes place in that time period. So it's sort of indirectly related to the Greek War of Independence. But that was sort of it. And then we just sort of build out from there. And then it was like, okay, if we're going to do this, let's go big. And let's see how far we can go back and how far, what can we, show that's more current. And when we realized that we wanted to talk to the creators of Blood of Zeus, Charlie and Blas Parlapanidis, it was like, well, that takes us all the way back to the very beginning, right, with Greek mythology. And then it was like, well, if we can do something with them, and at the time we weren't sure we would even get to show the pilot episode. And fortunately, Netflix made that available to us, which is great. But then it was like, why not get 300? And which was the epic Warner Brothers film about
King
Sparta. And then we just started thinking, okay, well, if we're going to do that, we have to get the definitive immigration, film, which was America, America.
We've done America, America, a classic, real
we've done
classic.
That many times in the past. And so we knew we would want to do something like that again. And then we were able to, pick up Beneath the Olive Tree, which was a film made by Stavrou Litoska, who was a former board member, and she's the writer, director, producer of that film.
Great documentary.
And then, Searching for Andreas, which Jimmy can maybe tell you more about that movie. And of course, I was personally very happy that we were able to show Road to Sparta, which is a documentary about a road race in Greece called the Spartathlon. It's a road race that takes place from Athens to Sparta. It's a 246 kilometer race. And it just so happens one of the runners that was profiled in that documentary is Dean Karnazes, who's from California, and he's a professional runner. And of course, he's such an interesting person. So it wasn't about like, let's just show the films. Let's see if we can't get these people to have a conversation with us about these movies. And so everything that we're offering, there'll be interviews with the creators and the filmmakers and some people just who are in and around these movies.
That in itself is amazing. I just to be able to come in and hear them speak about, the making of. I would love to get a little summary on each of these movies for our audience. I don't know who can jump in and give me a little brief summary of each of these movies that you're presenting, these eight movies. We could begin with Blood of Zeus. You can give me a little bit of information on Blood of Zeus.
Jump in. So we are so excited to be sharing the pilot episode of Blood of Zeus. It's Netflix's hit anime series. It's just a phenomenal series. We are so fortunate to have been able to speak with Charlie and Vlas Parlapanidis about the making of the series, their background. And they're just two really great guys. We were able to procure the first episode from Netflix. It's neat because you could see the rest of the season on Netflix, but at least just to have this first episode out, it really tells, a little bit of a specific tale, in Greek mythology without giving it away. It's based on Heron. It's just an incredible anime series. So we have the first episode of that. In addition, I'll take a few of the films. So, 300 is, just the epic Warner Brothers movie about the Battle of Thermopylae. And then we have Cliffs of Freedom. Actually, going back to 302, I should note Zack Snyder is the incredible director of the film. We're going to be speaking with him as well. And then Cliffs of Freedom, as George touched on earlier, is the, you know, it's kind of a tentpole film now for the Greek War of Independence, 1821. And same with God Loves Caviar. And then Jimmy or George, if you want to jump in on America, America.
God Loves Caviar is mostly in English. It has an international cast that includes Catherine Deneuve. Mm-hmm. And it tells the story of Yanis Varvakis, who's a very interesting character. Apparently, he started out as a pirate and landed up as a multimillionaire. Somewhere along the line, he gained the favors of Catherine the Great, who granted him exclusive worldwide trading rights to the caviar trade. And that made him a multimillionaire. And he gave all his money away. He actually became the first benefactor of the new Greek state. So it does tie in very nicely with the revolution. The director of that film is Yanis Maragdis, who has a reputation in Greece for making spectacles, big productions that are very rare in the Greek film industry.
That's a great story, Jimmy. I didn't even know about that. I can't wait to see any of these. And I'm sure our audience.
It's an interesting, and I love the title. Isn't that a wonderful?
Love the title. A story that has not been told.
And I know that Christopher Papakalliatis is a friend of yours. He's in this film. It's one of his very few films he appears in that he hasn't directed.
Yes.
So you'll catch a glimpse of him there.
Searching for Andreas? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yes, Searching for Andreas is a documentary. The Andreas, of course, is none other than Andreas Papandreou. It's a documentary directed by Professor Haris Milonas. The film really focuses on the life and career of Andreas Papandreou and asks, is he a socialist reformer or is he a populist manipulator? So it leaves that question hanging for every viewer to answer on his own. The film is, of course, not just about Papandreou's life and legacy, but it's a cautionary tale about the danger of over-reliance on charismatic leaders and the challenges that democracies face when it comes time to replace these leaders. It's a very, very interesting documentary and nicely done, intelligently done. It's a good, solid filmmaking. Very, very
and the
nice.
Road to Sparta, which is very interesting as well.
We have to refer to my friend George, who has championed that film for us.
Well, I've already sort of talked about it, but the Spartathlon race in Greece that takes place every year. I think it started in the early 80s. This documentary was shot in 2014. It features Dean Karnazes and three other runners, two English gentlemen and a woman from Athens. She's a nurse in Greece. So the film sort of profiles the four of them. But Dean is, you know, sort of known worldwide. And of course, being Greek and a professional runner, I mean, he runs for a living. And he's known as the ultramarathon man. In fact, he's also a best-selling author, and his first book was The Ultramarathon Man. He's published several other books since that book, which was, I think, first published 16 years ago. And in fact, he also came out with a book about his experience running that race called Road to Sparta, the same as the documentary. So I'm personally good friends with the director, Barney, co-director Barney Spender. So we were able to interview Barney and Dean. And if you watch the film, there'll be an audio recording conversation with the three of us that hopefully people will be able to go out for a walk or a run to listen to that. But they're really both fascinating people and really interesting to hear from them to talk about this this event.
I mean, guys, you've done a phenomenal job. The compilation of these films is absolutely amazing. I don't know, to all our audience, you guys have to log on and you know, support the Hellenic Film Society USA, because, you know, there's a lot of effort and love going into these projects, and we all have to support and try to get it out to a wider audience. Tell your friends about it. You know, they're mostly in English, if I'm not mistaken, if or not all in English, these films, and they have to do with Hellenism. And so we are celebrating 200 years of Greek independence. Tell us some of the hurdles you guys are facing. What are some of the hurdles today?
Well, you know, it's very rare that you will come across a director who doesn't want his film seen. One would think that it's relatively easy to get the films. It's not always the case. I think you have to earn the right to show the films. The directors have to be assured that their films will be treated professionally and with the respect that they deserve. And I think we've managed to do that. And of course, we always keep the audience in mind. We don't want to present films that insult the intelligence of our audience. We have sophisticated viewers, and we try to choose material that will be to their liking. And I know, as head of this organization, I am very, very grateful to my board members who work so diligently. We all share a mission, and I respect them enormously. And I'm very grateful to them for their assistance, which they provide willingly and so capably.
George is a friend. Costadina, you're a rock star. You're the new rock star. and so I'm very excited. But I'd like to offer some information to our viewers as well, all our filmmakers out there. How can they get their films to you? Tell me a little bit about the society and what are some of the events that you're also organizing?
Well, we do have, if filmmakers are interested in submitting films to us, if they go to our website, there is a special icon there for submissions, and they can read all the directions. The website is, of course, www.hellenicfilmusa.org. For the time being, our plan is to continue our monthly screenings on demand, and we hope to be back into the theaters late September with the New York Greek Film Expo 2021. It's a good year for Greek films. We've already lined up or are in the process of finalizing our selections. It's very hard to plan with certainty under these current conditions, but we hope that by September, people will be anxious to come back to the theaters. We had our last festival online, and although the films are wonderful, there's nothing particularly festive about an online festival. So we're very anxious to go back to the theaters and bring directors and actors right. to New York and share their films with us. And we're looking forward to that very much.
That's wonderful information. And I know you have two movies that you're offering for free. Do you guys want to tell us about which ones those are?
So Cliffs of Freedom will be available for free for the full 10-day run of our program, as well as the Blood of Zeus pilot episode. The other films, we're charging $8 a ticket. The America, which is, and 300, both are happen to be Warner Brothers films. We're showing them, they're not available for the full 10-day run. So America is available for the first 3 days of the program, so the 19th, 20th, and 21st, and 300 is available for the last weekend, which is the 26th, 27th, and 28th. Other than that, all the other films are you can access, you know, at any time during the 10-day program.
And George, you forgot to mention the special price of our pass, which happens to be $18.21. Right. So look out for all the details on our website for the dates and when things are showing. You know, it's 19 to 28, and the information is on our website, but we do have that special 18-21 price, so.
We thought we were being very clever with that.
It's not even so much about the money as much as it's just supporting, you know, our organization and what we're doing and Greek filmmakers and you know, it's obviously at $18.21, you might as well, you know, pay 20, but it just was, it was a fun way to emphasize what it is that we're doing, which this is all about, the 200th anniversary. And I think when you go to the website and you see the timeline and you look at these films, you'll see, you know, why we picked the films that we did going back to the Persian Wars. And of course, the Greeks have faced persecution against the Persians and then the Romans and then the Ottomans and even and then the Nazis in World War II and the Greek generals in the 70s and up to like the austerity measures that are that took place in the, you know, 2010 to 2018. And, you know, Greece probably still hasn't seen its way out of the crisis. But that movie, Road to Sparta, which took place in 2014, they talk about, because obviously it's about King Leonidas, you know, running from Athens to Sparta. And so they're very much, you know, retracing the footsteps of Pheidippides. And so you're hearing that story, but they're also showing the Greek people of today and the way that they live. And so that is very much part of the movie that they made. It's not just, let's just document these people running a road race. You're getting Greek history, you're getting Greek music, you're getting poetry, and you're getting...
Yanna, I assure you there is madness, rather there is method to our madness. It's the reason for everything.
Listen, I love it. It's great. We all need to, you know, support and... for all our viewers out there, celebration of Greek history going on through film right on HellenicFilmUSA.org. Take advantage of this wonderful time. See these great movies. They're classics. You really should watch them if you care about or if you're interested in anything that has to do with Hellenism. All, you know, our Philolines out there watching us March 19 to 28, you'll be able to watch these wonderful films. Support the Hellenic Film Society, guys, USA. And guys, congratulations, everyone. We look forward to seeing the films and we look forward to hearing more about what you're doing in the future.
Thank you, Yanna. We appreciate your support. And as I said, the opportunity to speak to your viewers. I hope they'll find several films to their liking, if not every film to their liking. Thank you.
Thank you, Yanna.
Thank you, Yanna.
Thank you.